गुड मॉर्निंग। Okay. The previous class we have seen the classification of the methods engineering. Methods engineering or work study that can be classified in this manner into two, that is mainly method study and work measurement. In the method study, what we are doing is we are analyzing the each methods or procedures. And in work measurement, we analyze the time study, or we make the study regarding the time taken for each procedure. And these all contribute to the high productivity that is given here. Okay, so we have seen all these advantages, aims, objectives, the scopes. Finally, we were discussing on the basic procedures. These were the procedures of a method study. And so first one was the select. We just select the method. Then we go to record where the data is being collected. Data is being collected and using many things like process charts, diagram, etc. Later on, we move to examine, where the purpose, place, sequence of every operation is examined. Then we move to develop. There we develop the process or the procedures. So which all things are practical and feasible, whether it is safe or effective, whether it is economical or it is acceptable to the other departments like design, production control, sales department, all. Then we develop the procedure. After all, then we move to install, where the procedure or the equipment is installed. After that, finally, we maintain the system. These were the basic procedures involved in the method study. Now we will go in depth to each thing, that is in the record option. We have already seen the first method, that is the first procedure, that is select is done based on the three categories like economic consideration, technical consideration and human consideration. Now regarding record, things using process charts and diagrams. First of all, we will see the process charts. What are the various process charts, or how the process chart is being used for collecting the data for the record. Okay, so what is a process chart? Process chart, actually this is a chart showing a process. What all processes are conducting or doing in a manufacturing unit, we will represent these processes in terms of a chart, or using a chart we will develop a chart so that the process will be picturized. So this is recorded graphically or diagrammatically in a sequence. The options connected with the process with the help of a set of symbols. So here we are using certain symbols like a circle, what we see in a flow diagram, flow chart. We have already learned in our small classes like flow charts and all. So similarly, similar chart is process chart also. Here also we are having certain symbols. In that flow chart and all, we have used some start stop. For start stop, we are using oval shape. For decision, we are using diamond shape. Like that, here we use certain symbols. Using these symbols, we record graphically these parameters or the process that we will see later. So the construction and interpretation of the process charts are simplified by the use of two or more symbols. So not only one symbol, but sometimes two or more, or even a combination of two or more symbols can be used. That will be seen. Yes. So in addition to the basic symbols, there are symbols of or combined activities. For example, for inspection, it is given a rectangle, and operation, whichever operation it is conducting, we use the circle. So some cases you can see a circle inside a rectangle. That means here a combined action, that is inspection and operation, is being conducted. So you can use the combined activities or the combined symbols also. So one by one we can see. First of all, operation. So what are the process chart symbols? There are basically five chart symbols. We are using five symbols, and then we will see some combinations also. Okay, so the first one is operation. So whichever operation is there, we will represent by a circle like this. Okay, so whether it is a turning operation or milling operation or drilling, anything. So these operations are denoted by this symbol, that is a circular symbol. Next, storage. So after a finished good is provided, then we will store it somewhere. So in order to show the storage operation, so this is a storage. For example, is given cutting tools lying in a tool store. So after finishing the cutting tool or producing a cutting tool, it is being stored in the tool store. So this particular activity is being shown by using this symbol. So why we are using these symbols? Because in order to describe a process, so it will be better that we can use these symbols so that you can store this procedure in a single paper or a single in a small size paper or a small area. We can place it using these symbols. Otherwise, you have to write the whole statements or the paragraph wise. So in order to make it simple, we use these symbols. So first one, we have in the operation. For operation, we have used circle. Then for storage, we have used triangle. Now next is the inspection. Wherever there is an inspection, for what is an inspection? Inspection means we are inspecting whether the product produced is of good quality or the quantity we require, the requisite quality or the requisite volume of production is met. So we inspect it based on the standard. Okay, so inspection, wherever inspection is there, we use this symbol, that is rectangle. Next is the transport of workers, material, equipment, etc., etc., anything that we have already seen, the material handling systems and all. So these type of activities are represented using the symbol, arrow symbol. whether it is in this direction or that direction, any direction, using the arrow symbol. So this is the transport symbol. And finally, delay, like D. Okay, suppose in any production, some product is waiting, say for nut and bolt assembly. Nut is being created and we have to wait for the bolt. Then we will use this symbol for delay. It is being delayed for this much time till the next unit comes. So in that case, we use the delay, and the delay symbol is D, or this much. So in addition to this, we use the combination. So which all are the symbols? First one, operation. Operation denoted by circle. Then storage denoted by triangle. Inspection by rectangle. Transport by the arrow symbol. Delay by D. Now, this is one of the combination, that is operation and transport. So sometimes it may be required to carry out an operation with transportation, along with transportation. That is, for example, we can see here, articles are being painted as they are transported by a chain surveyor, chain conveyor. So while it is being moved or transporting, at the same time, some procedure is being done. That is, the painting is also done. So simultaneously, the transportation and operation is doing at the same time. So we represent that process by this symbol, that is operation and transportation. Another scenario, that is inspection come operation. Inspection denoted by the rectangle and the operation by circular. For example, a powder milk tin is being weighted as it is filled. അങ്ങനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ വെയിറ്റ് നോക്കുന്നത് അല്ലേ. അതിൻ്റെ കൂടെ എന്താ, നമ്മൾക്കിപ്പോൾ ഇങ്ങനെ പാലിങ്ങനെ ഒഴിച്ചുകൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നതിൻ്റെ കൂട്ടത്തിൽ തന്നെ വെയിറ്റ് നോക്കുന്നു. ഇപ്പോൾ നമ്മൾക്ക് ഈ സ്റ്റേഷനറി ഷോപ്പിലൊക്കെ കാണുന്ന പോലെ എന്താണ് പഞ്ചസാരയൊക്കെ തൂക്കിയെടുക്കുന്നത് അല്ലേ. വി ആർ ഫില്ലിങ് ഇറ്റ് അറ്റ് ദ സെയിം ടൈം വി ആർ മെഷറിങ് ഓൾസോ. സോ ഇൻസ്പെക്ഷൻ കം ഓപ്പറേഷൻ. സോ ദീസ് ആർ സം ഓഫ് ദ സിമ്പിൾസ് യൂസ്ഡ് ഇൻ ദ process chart. Now we will see what are the types of process charts, and we will in each type we will see these symbols. So there are mainly four process charts we are discussing: process outline or outline process chart, then flow process chart, two handled process chart, multiple activity charts. In all these charts, what we see is these are a combination of these symbols connected by arrows, or a sequence number is given, and we will see one by one. First one is outline process chart, outline or operational process chart. So by the name itself, we will get an idea. That is a just this is just an outline of the process. The whole process, we are just giving an outline. We are not going in depth to the process, but just an outline. So it gives an overall view, just an overall view or a quick idea of the entire process. So by analyzing this chart, what we get is just a overall view, what all things it goes to milling, drilling, and finishing, and just the final product is being developed like that, and not into the internal parts, like suppose we say the labor or the worker is coming to the lathe, taking the workpiece, holding it into somewhere, and using this particular dimension he is facing it, then turning it, and all. So these things are not discussed, just saying that it is being turned or it is being machined in the lathe, and that later it moved to milling, like that. So this is just an outline process. This contains large number of lines, one fourth. So here you will see, I'll show you the chart. So here you will see a number of lines, more than one line. So each line for each product. Suppose if you have to have a assembly where a bar is created, then a casting is done, and a casting and a hexagonal nut is being assembled to that. Then each product you have each lines, and for first of all the main thing is the bar, MS bar. Then for MS bar you will have a particular fraction line of or for then for casting you have some other line, and for the hexagonal nut other line, and this will be connected to the main line that you will see in this figure. You can zoom this. Okay, this is the one. So here you can see the main line. This is the MS bar, for MS bar. Here you can see the MS bar, how the operations are being conducted. First one, this is an operation. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four operations are there. First of all, cut to length. Then cutting thread. Cutting thread. This is bending. And the time is given in the left side. Okay. So here you can see, if you zoom it, you can see that is, these are the sequence numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4. The sequence in which the operations are being conducted. And this is the description. What thing is being done? That is the cutting to length. Cut the thread. Cutting the thread, etc., etc. And here in the left side, you can see the time, time duration. Here, after that, there is an inspection. After that, you can see the combination, that is the inspection and operation, that is center distance, centering. So after this process, what happens is you can see another line is coming. That is here, you can see GI casting. There, inspection is being done, first of all, then drilling holes, then inspection, then inspect holes, machine radius, radius, seat, etc. And the time is being given in the left side. And another line, that is for the hexagonal nut, turning, drilling, tapping, parting off, and for finally the nut is being there. Here you can see a repeat once more, repeat once. So once again it repeats the process. Anyway, finally you will see a chart like this, where the frequency of inspection, how much inspections are totally given, that is here you can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here it is repeating, so twice. That is the total frequency 8, and the total time you can add this, you will get this value. Similarly for the operations also. So here in the outline process chart, you will use only mainly two things, that is operations and inspections. These are shown in the outline process chart. So basically, in any operation chart, what you have seen is just an outline or overall view of the process can be depicted in an outline process chart. And using this, you will get these particular ideas. Okay. So these are the main advantages. Advantages of a outline process chart, mainly to layout, plant and location. Using this chart, you can see after drilling you have to go for milling, tapping, etc., etc., and various other assembly activities also you can see. So using that data, you can define the layout of the plant and location can give. Here it shows the relationship between various parts which enter the final assembly. So in the last example also, you can see the main thing is the MS bar, and we are getting the hexagonal nuts and other things for assembly. So from the figure itself, you can get an idea that which all things are, which all parts are entering the final assembly. Now it helps the analyst to visualize the process for examination as a means of better understanding and improvement of the process. So the analyst who analyzes the process or the procedure, he can get a good understanding, or he can visualize the procedure or the process using these charts. So utilizing these charts, he can easily visualize the procedure and get better understanding, and it will help in improvement of the process. Next is the flow process chart. So flow process chart means it is chart. The last case we are having the outline, just an overall view. So if we have to move inside it or beyond that, in order to, we will magnify or we amplify the situation, and this is the done by flow process chart. So this here you can see other operations, other symbols also, like operation, inspection, storage, delay, transportation, etc., everything, and also the combination of these things. And here mainly two types, that is man type flow chart and equipment flow type of flow charts are used. Man type means regarding the man, how the man is moving, what is he doing, the procedure or anything related to the man, that is shown by man type flow chart. And material type flow chart means it is dealing with the material. So two types of flow charts, flow process charts are used. First one is man type and second one is the material type. You can see here, if you zoom it, you can see here, you can see the man type, and the symbols used here is, in this particular example, is operation, transport and inspection. And for the material type, we have used operation, transport, inspection, delay and also storage. So here you can see the man type, what all things are there, that is regarding the man, or taking in account to the what all things are happening in related to a man. So here you can see chart begins and chart ends. Chart begins is man in the inspection department, and chart ends is also man the inspection department. So first of all, what is being done? Transportation to good receiving. Okay, the goods are receiving. Then next, locate the component. Then pick up the component. Moving to inspection department, set the component to the bench. Visual inspection, measure and record length. Then put inspection seal, transporting to the stores, enter the stock, then he returned to the inspection department. So what all things the man is doing, that is depicted through the man type flow process chart using these symbols. Next, the regarding the flow of the material, here first of all, delay, await the arrival of the man. This material is waiting for the particular man to arrive. Then this material is being moved to the inspection department and it is kept on the bench, that is the operation. Then it is being inspected. After that, the measuring the dimension of each, and it is being stamped. The same thing, but it is happening on the material side. To stores, and after that it being stored on the this is the storage symbol. So these are the two types of flow charts, flow process charts used in the particular process. Now this is the two-handed process chart. Third type is the two-handed process chart. It means the process chart which records the activities of left hand and right hand. So left hand und right hand und ipo left hand in cheyna karyangal endana right hand. Appo for any process the movements are very important. What all things we are using, even the minute movement, small movements like thermics, we will discuss it later. Anyway, even micro motion or any motion, it is very important. So here what we focus is the activities which is done by the left hand, given by one process chart, and by the right hand we will use another process chart. So this is known as the operator activity chart, and you can see here the procedure done by the left hand is being given here and the right hand is given over here. Using his left hand, what he reaching for the bolt, bolt like ne pidikan povunu ennatte endu idu bolt ne ker pidichu, that is a grasp the bolt head, carry to center position, hold the bolt, ini adutha bolt eduthu, transfer the to the right hand, ennatte right hand like nammal kodukunu ennatte delay idu korchu neram. Ini right hand cheyyunnathu endana, reach for the bolt, bolt ethi ennatte endana grasp the nut, carry to the center position, place the nut, screw nut, gas only, what all thing. So that we will depict all using the right hand. So nothing, this is nothing but which all things or which all procedures are being done using the left hand is being given in the left hand section, and which all things we are doing in the using right hand is giving given in the this particular dash. So this is the two-handed process chart, and these are the main process charts. Then later we will move to diagrams. Now here in any process chart, in any process chart what we are doing is just the sequence of operations or the nature of movement only is given, but regarding the path of movement, how it is moving, that is not given using the process charts, that is given using only the diagrams, various types of diagrams, flow diagrams, string diagrams, etc. So that we will discuss in the next class.